1973 season, Vandy came on like gangbusters. Tearing, driving, diving, bucking, smashing their way to the goal, the black and gold bulldozed their way to 500 yards total offense against the University of Virginia. Nashville's Jesse Mathers, number 81, fooled the Cavaliers with a snappy split and reverse. Tailback Jamie O'Rourke, number 44, rushed for 173 yards, and quarterback Fred Fisher ate up the University of Virginia with needle-threading passes and smooth as silk handoffs. Defensive back Scott Wingfield, who went on to lead the SEC in pass interceptions, grabbed three loose balls out of the air for a game record. The Vanderbilt front wall knocked holes in the Virginia line big enough to lead the Commodore band through. And the black and gold defense, led by all-SEC tackle and the Cleveland Browns fifth-round draft pick, Mark Elgenfritz, number 77, nailed the Virginia offense with neck-snapping tackles as Vandy connected for their second big win.
Well, I woke up Sunday morning with no way to hold my head. That didn't hurt.
The Crimson Tide, the hottest team in the nation, rolled into Music City looking for an easy victory. Coach Bear Bryant stalked the sidelines as his team put a bear hug on the Commodores. Number 33, tailback Lonnie Sandler, tiptoed his way through a field full of bear traps as he turned in one of his finest games. Fullback Martin Garcia sliced his way through the big red wall to give the Commodores field position in their gutsy losing stand. But the Crimson Tide was just too much, and Vandy was in too deep that night.
And Sunday morning.
Decked out in water wings, Vandy backstroked their way to victory in the rain-drenched stadium against William & Mary. The Indians were on the warpath, but Vandy scalped them bad. Handling the slick ball with sure and steady hands, the Vandy offense played flawless ball and cheered on by some solid hometown spirit, committing not a single turnover, the black and gold held off the crunching Indian attacks. Vandy sent the Indians back to their reservation with a total of minus 2 yards passing and chalked up another win. Vandy, they played a win. Stocking up on muscle food at the team's dining hall and the girls' dorm at Branscombe Quadrangle, the Commodores stored up energy for the next Saturday's gymnastics. Coach Sloan and head trainer Jack Redgren, firm believers in the policy that hungry athletes play poor ball, served the Commodores some of the best food ever seen in these parts. And between the books and practice, the team spends some time with the coaches in McGugan Center, the sumptuous home of the Vanderbilt teams. In a new and modern atmosphere, it houses the training and office facilities for all the Vanderbilt teams. Commodores played their biggest game of the season against the Georgia Bulldogs. Although the Dogs hit the field like a pack of wolves, Sloan's men soon had the Bulldogs sitting up and begging. The Hawk, Hawkins Golden, swooped down on the grounded Bulldogs, hitting them for 4 field goals. Playing dog catcher, the defense held Georgia to only 1 first down the entire second half. Middle guard Tom Galbiers, number 54, patrolled inside, while defensive end Joe Reynolds, number 43, guarded the outside, watching for any stray dogs trying to sneak around the corners. Defensive cornerback Doug Nettles, a fifth-round draft pick of the Baltimore Colts, intercepted a game-breaking Bulldog desperation pass to send the Dogs home to Athens with their tail between their legs as Vanderbilt pulled off its biggest victory of the year. Final score, Vandy 18, Georgia 14. Vandy, they play to win. The black Black and Gold wandered deep into Dixieland for a tough battle with the rebels of Ole Miss. The South rose again as Ole Miss, playing flawless football, outgunned and outmaneuvered hard-playing Vandy. Taking a cue from the invisible man, the rebels somehow seemed to slip unnoticed through the Vandy line. Mickey Jacobs and Bo Patton plugged the holes and stopped most of the rebel chargers. Going on with the last-minute surge, Vandy tried to regain the high ground, but the rebels, using the clock, outweighed Vanderbilt. With a season record of 4-4 in their hip pockets, the Commodores jetted into New Orleans for a meeting with the nationally ranked Tulane Green Wave, taking the edge off of the pregame jitters with a little relaxation at New Orleans' famous French Quarter and a tour of Old Bourbon Street. Vandy tuned up for its game with Tulane, but the black and gold machine just couldn't seem to get into gear. The early field position and good running that moved the Commodores close to pay dirt time and time again seemed to evaporate as Vandy stood knocking at the door. Running at them and over them and under them and around them, the Commodores took the ball to them and had chance after chance stolen away. In the next outing, Vandy took a fly swatter, the University of Tampa's quarterback Freddie Superfly Solomon, as Vandy slammed the door on Tampa 18-16. Again, the Hawk, a draft pick of the Dallas Cowboys, swept down from his perch on the bench to put the game on ice. A ferocious goal line stand and super fine running by Jamie O'Rourke and Lonnie Sadler. The best 1-2 tailback combination in the SEC highlighted the afternoon. The ball seemed to have radar as it thudded unmolested time and time again into the receiver's sure hands. Again, the unstoppable combination of Fisher to tight end Barry Burton clicked again as Vandy fought their way to another win. Vandy, they play to win. Most of the balls were ready to volunteer for the swimming team as Vandy ground up UT. Ball quarterback Conridge Holloway, one of the best quarterbacks in the nation, spent so much time with his face in the dirt that the fans thought he'd taken up gardening. Game honors had to go to the Vandy defense as it defused the explosive ball offense and dumped a bucket of cold water on Tennessee's usually fiery running game. In the second half, Vandy recovered a Tennessee fumble and took the ball down to the one-yard line on a heart-snapping pass from Fisher to Barry Burton. Martin Garcia dove into the end zone for the first black and gold touchdown, making the score Tennessee 14, Vandy 7. Minutes later, the Commodores were knocking at the door again as Bubba Bird ran a punt back to the Tennessee one-yard line. Getting the call again, Garcia pushed the ball over to tie the game at 14-all. The Hawk capitalized on another Tennessee turnover, putting the Commodores ahead 17-14 as his golden toe came through again. At the end, the Vols managed to steal the game from Vandy with a last-second field goal, but it was an afternoon that left the 70,000 fans cheering their Commodores on and stirred up a firestorm of football fever in Nashville and throughout the state of Tennessee. Leading the Commodores to their best season in several years, Coach Steve Sloan exemplifies the new spirit of the Commodores football team, guiding the Crimson Tide to a number one national ranking and an Orange Bowl victory over Nebraska. Along with spending 2 years with the Atlanta Falcons, Steve is in the habit of winning and claims he's gotten two set in his ways to change his winning habit now. His assistants, Coach Dockery, Parcells, Patterson, Kropp, McIntyre, and Zeleznick, constitute a team of some of the finest coaching specialists in the country, with coaches Malone, Barnes, and Windham adding a bigger punch to the staff. Mainly due to the efforts of athletic director Clay Stapleton, Vanderbilt football has been completely rerouted. Another winner, Clay Stapleton, along with his teammate C.R. Bickerstaff, have worked to improve the Vandy football effort and assembled a top-notch coaching team. All in all, It was quite a year for Vandy. They came out fighting and played to win. The best season in over 10 years. A winning team. One of the country's best coaches. A winning athletic director. A top-notch staff. Several players drafted to the pros. Fewest number of turnovers in the SEC. Scott Winfield, number two in the nation in pass interception. And quarterback Fred Fisher leading the SEC in total offense and passing offense. But more than anything else, a winning club. Vandy, they play to win. These are the Vanderbilt Commodores, and I'm Dick Kent.